Hello, Mr. Hyperstrange! Mr. John Hyperstrange!
Hello, Necro. How are you today?
Oh, I'm doing fine, thank you. I hear you like business. Would you like to play business shark with me?
Business. He is a business shark. He does business. And he is a shark, so he's a business. He's a business shark. Whoa, whoa. Whoa, whoa.
Oh, no thank you. But look, I brought you a Zeb.
Oh, how wonderful! I really do like eggs!
I also brought you this comically large 1980s style human box.
What's this? It's playing music from before 1995?
Doom Eternal is a monument to its own excesses, then Eggwife is a monument to all of man's sins as well as their excesses, and is a very strange title to be taking a look at, once again thanks to the wonderful generosity of Hyperstrange. They know there's only three things I love in this world, and that's ass and titties. Get it? Cause titties is plural? But if there were three other things I love in this world, it's boomer shooters, jank games, and shitpost games. Enter 77p egg colon Eggwife. You are 77p Egg, a stick figure furry with high aspirations of veganism. However, due to a tragic mining-themed sex accident, you find yourself tragically widowed.
Hey, honey, mind my coat hunt with your dick axe.
Okay, Harry!
I'm dead, oh dear.
Salt! Not like dumb!
Making your way out into the rainy streets of Sheffield, Egg finds that the world is not so welcoming of his special brand of anal fisting, and must battle his way through the Pisco supermarket just to find himself deeply embroiled in the machinations of a lactose intolerant cult of the cow god. Shortly thereafter, it starts raining poop asteroids, destroying the surrounding area and Sheffield itself. Yeah, it's not every day where I can just start spewing nonsense, and you can never be truly sure if what I've said is my own drunken ramblings or is that of somebody else. But the grander point being that 77p Egg Studios sought to answer one question. Can you develop a game if the entire time spent working on it was only spent consuming psychedelics and flaming hot Cheetos?
I am back from checking my privilege. It's fine.
The answer is obviously yes, otherwise we wouldn't be here, but the larger answer is yes, and it's going to be a wild romp of a ride, spewing ordinance and humor that makes Postal 2 seem tame in comparison. The Steam page promises 10 levels, though I only had access to 9 at the time of writing, but also features bonus levels and a wave mode. Levels, while not overly deep in any of their designs, focus a lot more on creating a surreal style of exploration. Mostly pretty linear, with only a couple levels being focused on a bit more open exploration, it comes off a little more Dark Forces 2 than most boomer shooters tend to want to. While straightforward and challenge-based for most of the runtime, it also takes plenty of time to indulge itself by delving into a bit of the obtuse design, as well as some lengthy vehicle segments. While the vehicle segments are fun and a breath of fresh air, the former makes itself more prominently present during a boss fight against a nightmare cow god in which the player must do the one thing they don't want to. That being go to where the hurt water is, examine a crack in said hurt water, and then chain smoke some heroic doses of pot and pissing like a madman to avoid melting in a lava flow. Again, with absolutely no inkling that you would otherwise want to look there and go do that thing. The boss fight, however, features a towering meat mass spewing cow and milk puns at you.
Maybe you should be forever.
Overall, fuck it, 10 out of 10, we'll play again. So while some levels have little segments of why did you do it like this, it tends to just roll off the player's back as why did you do this pretty much describes the game. Everything feels like a trip that requires you to reach a higher plane of existence to really understand, so it's less of a shock when the little idiosyncrasies show up. There's a lot happening at just about all times. Even during the quiet exploration segments, there's always something new to see, read, or point and laugh at. It's definitely a game you want to take slowly, as there's always going to be at least two new and bombastic things going down at any given time, and that's not even taking into account the amount of drug trips the player will send Egg on. So you know, if you're completely brain fried like I am, it's fucking perfect, and you're goddamn right, ever since it was originally shown off, I was just waiting for it. Unreasonably excited for the release. Absurdism goes to some pretty interesting heights as enemies make up piss, shit, and cum bubbles, aforementioned cow cultists, piss-infected cows, biblically accurate angels spewing vomit, disembodied punk rock enthusiast testicles, and more. There are no small encounters after your endeavors to purchase a new wife from Pisco, and the pure anarchy just reigns all throughout. But as it's a monument to absurdity and excess, the weapons must of course oblige. Melee brings you a guitar, the pistol is a piss-filled water gun, a dildo firing crossbow which when using lubed fired mode will bounce around dealing damage to a larger area of enemies. The minigun is a pair of udders firing milk, the BFG is powered by cow souls, and of course every boomer shooter needs a double barrel, but that's passé. Nightmare Reaper and Proteus have already moved well into the quad barrel segment, so why not seven? Why not a seven-barreled shotgun? After all, seven! And what about Quake's nail gun? Or the nail gun from Postal Colon Brain Damaged? Well, Egg gets himself a nail gun too, and it's a nail gun. That's not very excessive, so how about dual wielding? Not excessive enough for you? You want to spew enough literal hardware to make Bob Vila pray for this old house? Well, bring on the motherfucking triple-wielding nail guns! Head on down to your local Home Depot and get yourself some meth! Also, the sniper rifle fires tampons. There are more than 10 weapons to equip, each as ridiculous as the others, with no less than 4 and most likely somewhere around 6 power-ups the player can gain access to. And yes, Boomer Juice is one of them. Look, the whole situation is wild. It's pure insanity, and it's going to make all the jokes you don't want it to make, and it's going to cram an entire fist in your rectum while it's doing it. Your double jump is powered by violently shitting, so you have to eat or cram things up your poop chute at a pretty constant rate, and Egg is going to tell you all about it while he does. Even the soundtrack is wildly off-kilter to match the setting, and the graphics really make one question if what they're seeing is real or not. It's pure insanity at a level most indie developers aren't willing to go, and more than any game they've published, really exemplifies Hyperstrange's name. Egg is fast, control is smooth, and gunplay packs a satisfying punch as you spew ordnance at the forces of piss and bovine divinity. If Slayer's X is a weird and hard game to talk about for being such a weird time capsule of a T-rated passion project, 77P Eggwife is hard to talk about because it's a game that has to be experienced to be truly understood. It defies description, and no amount of talking about it is ever going to do it justice, as what you have to say about it just makes you sound crazy. How many developers are crazy enough to let the player flip themselves upside down and spew rockets at a testicle as it fires monstrously sized sperm at you? One. Just one, and you have to go directly to them to get a really good look at just what a proposition the game is. Are you completely insane? No? Oh. Well, if you just want a game with all the immature humor your little prison pocket can contain, large levels with a wide variety of gameplay and more guns than you can keep track of, with each being as devastating and satisfying as the last, a plot and story that only ramps up its stakes and consequences as it goes, and a sense of humor that will definitely get you banned from several social media sites, Eggwife is the game for you. It's weaponized autism and the postal for a new Datura-filled generation, and I am the NecroSwanson, and you can go fuck yourselves.
Thank you.